Hello and welcome back to another video. My name is Mike Davies, and in today's tutorial, I'll be showing you a quick and effective way to change any color in your images using GIMP. I'll be using GIMP version 2.10.22, which is the latest version of GIMP at the time of this tutorial. Before I get into that, don't forget to check out my website at daviesmediadesign.com. As always, I have tons of GIMP and Inkscape tutorials on here. You can get more by becoming a DMD Premium member, and I have tons of free software help articles, so definitely check that out. You can enroll in my GIMP 2.10 Masterclass from beginner to pro photo editing on Udemy, and as I mentioned, you can get more with a DMD Premium membership, and I'll include a link to this as well as all the relevant links from this tutorial in the description of the video. Here is the photo I'll be using to demonstrate today's tutorial, and here is that photo opened up inside of GIMP with the new color. So here's a before, here's an after. Let's dive right in here. For starters, we're going to want to open up our photo, so I'll go to File, Open, and locate that file on my computer, or just go to Open Recent, and I'm going to select this photo right here. And I'm just going to come over and click Convert to convert this to GIMP's built-in sRGB color space. Now our original photo is opened up, and by the way, I did download the 1920 by 1280 version of this photo. But the first thing we'll do is come over here to the layers panel, and I'm just going to duplicate the original layer. Once I've done that, on the duplicate layer, I'm gonna go to colors, map, rotate colors. That's gonna bring up the rotate colors dialog. So this is going to be a filter or effect that allows you to pick a source range from the image, so that's your original color, and change that range of colors to the destination range. So that is going to be whatever you want your new colors to be. So here we are at the very top source range. Our source color is going to be this pinkish color. So what we wanna do is come over here to this little color wheel. You'll see an angle, and this is just gonna be two arrows. So basically, click in the middle of these two arrows and drag your mouse. That's going to change the range of colors that this filter is selecting. So in this case, we know we have this pinkish color. So that is going to be the color we mainly want inside the range. Of course, because this is a photo or a raster image, colors aren't ever just going to be a single color. They're going to contain various shades and other hues. So the range of colors, just make sure that you do select the various types of colors that can show up inside what looks like a single color to our eyes. So hold control, and it's a good idea to zoom in on the things that you're trying to select. So in this case, the car, the pants, and the pink pattern in the shirt, just to make sure that everything is indeed being selected here. So if I hold control, zoom in, you can see there's probably a little bit of pink that's not being selected right here. So what I can do is come over, and you'll see we have two sliders. We have the from slider and the to slider. These correspond to the two arrows. So you can see when I hover my mouse over one arrow or the other, it's going to highlight one of those arrows depending on which one I'm hovered over. So you can see here, I can click and drag this slider to change the from arrow, which is this one here, or I can click and drag the to slider. Of course, if we start to not select these magentas or these pinkish colors, now all of a sudden our pink car is no longer having its color changed. So we do want to make sure we get all of those shades inside of this range. And there you can see now we're starting to select parts of that car. And I'll hold control, zoom out. You can also middle click with your mouse wheel to manually set a numerical value here, or of course use the arrows. So let me slide over. And we can always move this. So there's parts of the tailpipe here that aren't really being selected. So once again, we can make adjustments to this. So maybe about right there. Hold control, zoom out. Of course, there's always give and take with this. So sometimes when you include more colors, you do select smaller objects like that. But maybe you also start to introduce some color changes to main elements, such as her face right here. And you can also see parts of the lips are being selected that maybe we don't want selected. So really, you're just gonna have to decide what you're okay with not being selected and what you're needing to be selected. So there's a couple of other buttons and stuff down here. So for example, clockwise is going to invert what's being included inside of the from and to range. So it's just reversing the angle outside the arrows here. So you can see what happens there. She looks like she belongs inside of an Avengers movie or like a Star Trek movie or something. So if we uncheck that, it's going to swap that back to inside of the from and to arrows. You can also click invert range, which is going to invert the from and to slider values, or select all. That's just going to basically select all of the colors inside the color wheel. So every color inside of the image will then be subject to change. So let me come back here and just make sure we invert this back to the way we had it. So the destination range is going to be the new color that you want to change this to. So right now we are saying that the colors inside of this range are going to be changed, and they're going to be changed to the colors inside of this range. That's why this looks a bit more yellow right now, because we're kind of centered on this yellow color. So everything inside the destination range is the same as the source range. So you have the from and to sliders for changing the location of the arrows. So you can either expand the range of colors that it's going to be changed to, or you can shrink them. And of course, we can click inside of here and manually drag this around the color wheel. And you can see as we do that, it is changing the color here, that pink color, to whatever color this range is centered on. And of course, we can do clockwise to swap the range of colors to outside those arrows, or you can invert the range. But I'm going to keep this set to the default setup as I search for a color I want to change this to. Finally, below the source and destination ranges is the gray handling. The gray handling is basically our way of pointing out to GIMP that these colors that we set here in this area are the gray colors in our image. And then we're telling GIMP how to handle those gray colors once we establish what they are. So inside of here, we have the color wheel down here to the right. The very top slider is the gray threshold. So this is just expanding the number of colors considered gray. So as I drag this slider up, you'll see everything in the image is basically going to be turned to gray. So let's bring that back down. This dropdown is telling us what to do once we determine what exactly is gray. So it's saying to either treat as this or change to this. So let's go to change to this first. It's a bit easier to explain. So basically up here inside the source range, the gray colors are going to be these desaturated colors. So this gray handling is saying take the gray from that range and change it to the color I designate here. So you can see the gray from this range, which is going to be like these areas here, are now being changed to the color I've selected here. And you can either click and drag your mouse, or you can manually adjust the slider. So the hue is going to rotate this around the color wheel and just select a new color, whereas saturation is either going to bring it closer towards the middle, which will be less saturation, or further out towards the edges, which is more saturation. So you can see that there. So the other option is treat as this. So that's saying all of the gray areas inside our source range, we want to treat those colors the same way we're going to treat colors located at this particular point. So this part's a little confusing, but basically you can match this point up to right here. So all of the gray areas of our image are going to be treated the same way that these colors in this area right here are treated. So that's going to be basically like converting them in this case to a bluish color or a tealish color. Just because this area right here corresponds to this area on the destination range. So this part you're going to have to play around with. You're going to have to figure out which colors in the source range correspond to particular colors in the destination range. So for example, if I drag this over towards red, it appears that the red color corresponds closer to the bluer color. And if I come over here and drag it towards this corner here, so the bluer corner, that's going to correspond to the green. On the other hand, if you want to make sure that the gray colors inside your range are treated as gray, make sure that you click and drag this towards the center or manually set the hue and saturation to zero. This can actually be helpful because you might have some spots in here or in other places around your image that had the destination colors assigned to it, but you actually wanted those colors to remain gray or desaturated. So this can help your destination colors from bleeding out into unwanted areas in your image. And we can do a split preview. So this was the original color. This is the new color. I'll click OK. So this effect will by no means be perfect right off the bat, so you may need to tweak some things. Let me show you what I do. So for example, if I hold Control, zoom in, you can see there's some blue areas here on her face and hair, and then also some pixelated areas. First off, let's get rid of this blue by coming over here. We'll right click, go to Add Layer Mask, and choose white full opacity and click add. Grab the paintbrush tool and we're going to select black. Let's decrease the brush size. So anywhere we paint black on a layer mask is going to get rid of the pixels on that layer. So because we have the original layer below this blue layer, that's allowing us to bring back some of the original colors from this image. So we don't need all this stuff being blue. We just need anything that was pink before to be blue. And there's also some areas here on her hands that can be cleaned up. Very simple. And some of the areas of the hair have a bit too much blue. You may find that some of this stuff should have a bit of the new color just because of the way light is reflecting off of the old color. So as we get closer to the bottom of the hair, you'll notice some of the pink may start to come through. So don't erase too much of that. And then this hand as well. You can see there is some pink right there, so I'll hit Control Z. We don't need to totally get rid of that, but we could tone it down and also blend it a bit. I have my hardness set pretty low on this brush, which is allowing me to softly erase the edges here as opposed to there being a hard edge everywhere I'm erasing. And that just helps to blend this. So there is pink, so I'm gonna hit X to switch to white. And anytime I paint white on my layer mask, that's gonna bring those pixels back. Finally, for the portions of her face here that are a little bit pixelated looking, I can click directly on this layer and hit the H key or grab the heel tool from my toolbox. Hold Control, zoom in. Let me decrease the size of the paintbrush a bit. Hold Control and click. So I'm gonna grab a nearby area, and if I just quickly paint some strokes here, you'll notice I'm painting and releasing. That's gonna help blend those pixels in there. So here as well. And come down here, hold Control, click. I do have an entire tutorial dedicated to the heel tool if you wanna learn how to use this. But there you can see now it's nice and blended, and there's our final photo. All right, so that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully you liked it. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to be notified each time I have a brand new tutorial. You can check out any of the links to my resources in the description of the video, but thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.